Hi everyone, welcome to my channel Human Diseases and Genes. Today I will discuss about Angelman Syndrome. Angelman Syndrome was first described by British pediatrician Dr. Harry Angelman in 1965. Dr. Angelman observed a group of children with similar characteristics including severe developmental delay, ataxia, and a distinctive happy demeanor. His detailed description of the condition was pivotal in identifying Angelman syndrome as a distinct clinical insight. It is a rare genetic disorder that primarily affects the nervous system and causes developmental and intellectual delay, as well as other physical and behavioral symptoms. It is often associated with a happy, excitable demeanor and frequent laughter. The prevalence of Angelman syndrome is relatively low but consistent across the population. It occurs in approximately 1 in 12,000 to 1 in 20,000 live births worldwide. And it is found in both males and females, and the incidence is generally similar across different Asian and ethnic populations. Life expectancy for individuals with AS is generally normal, but the quality of life can be affected by the severity of symptoms and the need for ongoing care and support. Symptoms include happy demeanor, hyperactivity, seizures, microcephaly, developmental and cognitive delays, severe intellectual disability, speech impairment, movement and balance problems, etc. Angelman syndrome is caused due to defect in a genetic mechanism called genomic imprinting. Genomic imprinting refers to the different expression of a gene depending on its parent of origin. In some regions of the genome, only one allele from either the mother or father is active, while the other is silenced. This silencing is a normal process that occurs through chemical modification to the DNA, such as DNA methylation and histone modification. In most genes, both the maternal and paternal copies are expressed, but for imprinted genes, the expression is parent-specific. In the case of Angelman syndrome, the UBE3A gene on chromosome 15 is imprinted in it in a way that only the maternal copy of the gene is active in neurons, while the paternal copy is normally silenced. Therefore, if the maternal copy of UBE3A gene is deleted, mutated, or otherwise non-functional, the result is a loss of the gene in the brain, leading to the characteristic symptoms of Angelman syndrome. Angelman syndrome is primarily caused by a loss of function of the UBE3A gene located on chromosome 15 at position 15q11 to q13. It spans approximately 100 kb of DNA and consists of 16 exons. This gene encodes a protein that is crucial for normal brain development and function. The UBE3A gene codes for a protein called UBE3A, also known as E6AP, which is a E3 ubiquitin ligase. This protein plays a crucial role in attaching ubiquitin molecules to other proteins, marking them for degradation by the proteasome. Loss of the maternal copy of UBE3A gene is caused by four different molecular mechanisms. First one is 3 to 5% of the cases show paternal uniparental disomy, Second one is 3 to 15% of imprinting defects ultimately result in silencing of the maternal. UBE3A gene expression. This includes a small deletion within the PWS1C region that affects DNA methylation in 10% of these cases. 10 to 20% are caused by intragenic mutation in the maternally inherited UBE3A gene, and the most prevalent type, about approximately 70 to 80%, is de novo maternal inherited megadeletion of 15q11 to q13 chromosomal region, including the UBE3A gene, that occur mostly in previously identified breaking point. Diagnosis of AS is often based on the characteristic clinical features and developmental history. Confirmatory diagnosis is made through genetic testing to detect deletions, mutations, or other abnormalities in the UBE3A gene. Testing for methylation patterns can help differentiate Angelman syndrome from other similar conditions. Brain imaging may be used to evaluate structural changes, but is not diagnostic on its own. There is currently no cure for Angelman syndrome. Management focuses on addressing symptoms and improving quality of life. Early intervention with therapies such as physical therapy, occupational therapy, and speech therapy can help maximize developmental potential and improve functional abilities. Anti-epileptic medications and treatments may be used to manage seizures. Special education services and behavioral therapies can help to address developmental and behavioral changes. This is all about Angelman syndrome. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful and learned something new, please like this video and don't forget to subscribe for more health insights. Share this video with friends or family to spread awareness. If you have any questions or personal experiences or stories with this disease, drop a comment. Don't miss my next video. Until then, stay informed and take care of your health. Thank you very much.